I have been educating people a lot about solar energy, and every time I came to the conclusion that actually the main topic is not solar. Solar is not the issue. Actually, one of the main issues is the general understanding of energy. Yeah, so there is an extreme problem in humanity, which I call energy illiteracy. People don't understand the phenomena of energy. And one of the fundamental reasons behind that is that energy has always been quantified in different units. Yeah? Like, for example, you talk about oil, you talk in barrels, you talk about coal quantities, people talk in metric tons, gas is in cubic feet. Fuel you buy at the fuel station, you talk in liters. Energy from the grid, you talk in watts. And so it's all energy, but people quantify it in different units. When you have so many different units for quantification of energy, people get completely confused. They can't compare one form of energy to another form of energy. And that is actually the basic problem of in understanding solar, because solar is, in fact, the ultimate source of all energy sources. But because people are so used to it, they don't see it as one of the major suppliers of energy. If you look at how humanity was using energy and still is today, the way people access to energy is by burning stuff. Yeah? Burning stuff, it's basically a 200,000 years old technology. When mankind first discovered fire, that was the discovery of burning things and used that, the energy output from that burning for their advantage. Yeah? And if you look today, 90% or even 98% of all energy consumed in the world is accessed through the method of burning, which is a totally ridiculous way of accessing energy. If you can access energy from the ultimate source directly, go to the cleanest source available, that is of course the most obvious way to access your energy. And one important aspect of that is that light energy is available all around the planet. It's a distributed form of energy that is already there for everybody to tap into. Yeah, so it's the most obvious source to use. And if you look into the numbers of it, it is an absolutely amazing amount of energy that is supplied from the sun. So it is a no-brainer to get to use that source for all your needs. Every roof of every household is more than sufficient to energize all their appliances in the house, including the energy needed to drive a car. So the word power is used as a synonym for electricity, while in fact power, the true meaning of power is the political issues behind it. Yeah, those who have power own the energy source. If you own the energy source, you have power. And if people have their own energy source, they have individual power. So what most people have in their homes today is an access point to so-called power, which is actually just electricity. But they don't have power, they just have an access to that energy source. Those who control the energy systems, those have the power. Right? Those who control the oil resources and distribute it and get it to people's households, those own the power. You just get an amount of energy. When you have an abundance of energy falling on your roof every day, yeah, it's your source. Yeah? So when you have that source available, you have your own power. So that means decentralization of power. So for example, in Nepal, yeah, that was one of the countries where people were just without any subsidies were buying solar systems. Yeah? And the market was like flourishing. Yeah? And what happened, a market that was already flourishing, there a World Bank program got announced to provide subsidies. Yeah? And widely announced to the population that this subsidy program is coming. And of course, if people know that something is coming that makes the products cheaper, they stop buying. So this is what we have been facing everywhere. South Africa, exactly the same issue. South Africa was a fantastic market in the early stage. No government programs at all. People were buying solar just with their own money. They could afford it. And this, although in the beginning, of course, it was small, but it started growing exponentially until a big donor support project came in, announcing these huge projects, keeping business owners distracted from the business that they're actually doing. The ultimate goal of power is to get everybody on that grid line. If you look at the present infrastructure of the world, where you have an electricity grid, millions of people connected to an electricity grid with absolutely no storage into this grid. So if a power station falls out, the whole millions of people without access to energy, which is totally nuts. It's such a vulnerable system, which is totally unnatural. There's nothing in nature that is constructed in that way. And I always believe that nature is your best inspiration to design anything. Nature has been there for millions of years, getting it right. So that is your most important inspiration. And if you look at nature, how does nature manage its energy? Energy is distributed throughout every cell. Like look at the human body. There are 100 trillion cells in a human body. In every cell, there is an energy factory. The mitochondria are the energy plants. They produce the energy. Not in one place, no, it's distributed through every cell of your body. It's constructed in that way, and that is the ultimate sustainability design, distributed energy. Actually, at the moment, I don't feel it's anymore a matter of sabotage anymore. Now the big guys, the big power, is already into solar. So there's no worry at all anymore about solar being the future. No doubt about it. Solar will be the main energy source for the future. But not distributed, centralized. Centralized harvest of the energy, centralized control of the distribution of it, and full control through the distribution system of that energy. So the ultimate strength of solar was actually the decentralization aspect of it. But that has not been achieved. So now that the technology has so matured that harvesting electricity from the sun is cheaper than harvesting from a coal-fired plant. So no doubt about that, solar is the future. It is already there. It is, even many countries, it's illegal to not have an connection to the grid. You can't even buy a plot of land or build a house without having a connection to the utility grid. So you're forced to get a building license or whatever. You have to get a connection to the grid. So that is the form of control. But who is doing it now is the big guys. The big guys that control the distribution, that control the production of the solar technology. So they are now fully invested into the whole infrastructure to produce solar. They control the business. But no decentralization.